Hello, my name is Martin and this is 3D Printing Iceland. In this video of Makerbox Mondays, I'm going to have a look at the ApolloX filament from Form Futura. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is called ApolloX and it's an ASA based filament. So let's have a look at the stickers. So here they say the print temperature should be 235 to 255, and bed temperature should be 80 to 90, and speed should be set at medium. I don't know the definition of medium speed. It really depends, but I guess that's maybe 30 to 40 millimeters per second. And here they say you should have a enclosure and the ventilation treat like ABS. And they say a lot of things here about the filament, and I'm gonna read this out. ApolloX is a professional high performance engineering filament which is based on a unique industrial grade modified ASA compound. ApolloX has been modified to have great thermal stability, improved filament flowing behavior, zero warping, and flawless first and interlayer adhesion, allowing you to 3D print optics with almost injection molded precision. ApolloX is UV and weather resistant, and by that ensuring great color stability combined with high strength and heat resistant properties makes ApolloX a perfect engineering filament from outdoor and automotive applications. And you can have a look at Form Futura website for more information, but that's quite a statement for a material. I printed out some tests and I want to show you. So the first thing I tested was a mechanical part. This is a small device that goes onto an edge on my oven that I can put on my headphones. So it's like a mechanical part, and I was comparing this to a PLA printed part, and this can bend a little bit more. It gives a tiny amount, while the PLA part was really stiff. But it holds its shape real well, and I didn't have any warping while printing. The surface finish is really nice, and as you can see, it prints really, really nice. And no issues with print quality. So that was definitely a good option for this filament. I then printed out my maker coin. That has really steep overhangs here, and that shows because I didn't print with part cooling on, then the underside of the part is struggling here, but on the side it was giving me good results, and the backside was pretty good. It was just the overhangs that were giving me trouble, and that also shows in the letters. They are somewhat like squished together, but the parts that didn't have overhangs came out excellent. And that's just one thing: when you have the part cooling turned off, you have trouble with overhangs, and that's really expected. And I decided to print out this benchy, and here you can see the overhang had an issue, but otherwise it came out pretty nice. The bridging here on the windows had some issues, and then the top chimney had an issue, and here I should have maybe set it in the slicer to slow down the print for this part. I didn't have to print on the same print speed, but here the chimney got all messed up. But that could be battled, but that could be remedied by printing a little bit slower and maybe having the fan a little bit off on. But I decided to try to print with the part cooling fan on, and I had it at 50% for this print, and I actually ran out of filament at this point. But with this print, the layer adhesion is really poor, so you can't really print out with the part cooling fan on. I could easily break the model apart, and I just want to show you what happens if you turn on the fan for this filament. You really have to slow down the print if you want to print fine details, but it looks pretty good though. So this was just a test to see what would happen with the part cooling fan on. This will be it for the ApolloX from Form Futura. I think with, for the mechanical parts like this one, it's a really good option. It's a great strength in the part and it prints really easy, and they have pretty bold statements on the note there about print quality and stability of the material. And I haven't done any outdoor testing at this point with this filament, but I believe that ASA is a good option for outdoor applications because of the UV resistant properties. So it's a good option for mechanical parts that need to be outside. So I would definitely give this filament a go if you have the option to buy this. But this will be it for this video. I hope you like this video, and if you do, give it a thumbs up and share and like and subscribe and all that. So for now, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.